You've had that silly grin on your face ever since we left the airport. Come on, when do I get to hear the news?
Oh, what makes you think I have news?
Oh, I know that look, Maggie. Either you've got some good news or you just saw Hare Krishna getting his robe caught in the baggage carousel.
Well, maybe I do, maybe I don't.
Ooh, you love teasing me, don't you?
I am not teasing you. I know something you don't know.
So take it, the story on Senator Howard went well.
Uh-huh.
And you got lots of good material for your column. And...
So what's new?
Either you talk or I'm going to turn this car into oncoming traffic.
Okay. Not only did I get a great interview for the paper, but Senator Howard was very impressed with me.
There's a semi approaching, Maggie. Spill it.
The senator offered me a job.
What?
Executive Director of Media Relations.
Oh, well, that's fantastic.
With a great salary.
Yay!
Yes! There's only one small catch.
What? No parking space?
Oh, yes, with my name on it.
Ah.
But it's in Washington, D.C.
Ah.
Show me that smile again. Show me that smile. Don't waste another minute on your crying.
I can't tell you what an ego boost it was to have the senator insist I take this job. Do you know what it's like to have someone begging at your knees?
Well, just when Mike needs gas money.
And the executive search committee has stopped looking for any other candidate.
Honey, that's very flattering. I guess you really surprised them. I mean, there's not many women walk out of a senator's office saying no. Would have loved to have seen the look on that craggy old geezer's face.
Jason, Senator Howard is a woman.
Oh, well, that explains the pearls he wore on Nightline. So how'd she take it when you turned her down?
Well, actually...
You did turn it down, Maggie.
There was a no in my heart, but I'll think about it came out of my mouth.
Well, why didn't, no, my family lives in New York, come on.
Well, Jason, what was I supposed to say? Sorry, I can't help you chart the world's geopolitical future. There's a pork festival at the Piggly Wiggly.
Simple stuff it, Senator, would suffice.
Oh, really? And would you have said stuff it if you'd been offered the perfect job?
The Islanders already have a goalie.
Jason, I'm serious.
Well, Maggie, if it meant unemploying my spouse and uprooting my children, yes, of course, I'd have to say no.
Well, obviously, I'm turning it down. But you could have at least let me revel in the fantasy for a minute before tightening down the guilt screws.
I'm sorry. Let's revel.
Now I don't feel like it.
Oh, come on, Maggie, please. I'm begging for details now.
Well, it is kind of impressive. I would have had a staff of 20 people.
Whoa.
I would have been testifying before Congress and lobbying for consumer rights.
You in Congress?
Yes, I would have had a major voice in shaping legislation. I would have actually had more to say in the running of this government than Marilyn Quayle.
I had no idea it was this big.
Oh, honey, it's the perfect blend of journalism and rights advocacy. It's everything I've ever wanted in a job. Oh, boy, I just realized the longer I put off turning this down, the sadder I'll be. I'm going to call the senator right now.
Maggie, you can't turn this job down.
Now you rebel.
No, honey, I'm serious. I'm deadly serious. This job's just too good for you to refuse.
Jason, this is nuts.
Oh, well, wait a minute. We've been taking care of the kids all these years. Haven't we always said we needed to do something for ourselves?
Well, I always assumed you meant his and her massages at Mr. Steve's.
Maggie, think about this.
Jason, what about your practice?
Well, I've wanted to do some clinical work. There are great clinics in Washington. Maggie, maybe it's time that I shook my life up a little bit, too.
But what about yanking the kids out of school?
Oh, Carol's an adult. Mike's over 21.
Well, what about Ben and Chrissy?
Honey, they're cute. Somebody will take them in. Honey, this could be a great opportunity for them.
You mean just pick up and move?
Well, we'll discuss it with the whole family.
Oh, Jesus.
I just thought of another fringe benefit.
What?
If you get on Good Morning America, I could meet June London.
What is the Seaver Summit anyway?
Well, it's a super-duper important family meeting.
Presumably important enough to make us miss Crossfire with Pat Buchanan and Pee Wee Herman.
So important that we've only had two in my lifetime. The last one was to tell us you were going to be born.
Yeah, and the other one was when you got caught singing I'm Looking Under a Two-Legged Wonder during nap time.
All right, glad you're all here.
This better be good.
Oh, it is. At least we hope you all think it is.
Oh, my God, you're going to have another baby.
No. But your mom does have some exciting news she'd like to share with you.
We're finally getting a dog?
No. We're moving.
For what?
No way. No kidding.
No dog?
I mean, we might move. That is, if you all...
Maggie, why don't you just back up and start at page one?
Everybody sit down. You all know that I've been doing a series of interviews with Senator Howard.
Yeah, isn't he that guy who wore pearls on Nightline?
Senator Howard is a woman.
Get out of town.
And yesterday, she offered me a job as executive director of media relations.
Oh, that's fantastic. Great,
Mom. Well, that's sad.
If I take the job, that means moving the family to Washington, D.C.
Too bad. Sounded like a great gig. Well, I'm off to Stinky's.
The Seaver Summit is far from over.
She's your woman, Dad. You straighten her out.
Sit or pay rent.
What's going on here?
Well, honey, Mommy is thinking about getting a new job.
You're not going to be my mommy anymore?
Oh, no, sweetheart. I will always be your mommy. But we are thinking about moving to a wonderful place called Washington, D.C.
Murder capital of the USA? That's what I heard on hard copy.
Well, obviously, we have a lot of questions to ask, a lot of things to talk about over the next couple of days.
Oh, boy, it means a lot more boring chit-chat until Mom finally comes to her senses.
Mike, I really don't appreciate your cavalier attitude towards Mom's career.
Yeah? Well, that's the difference between you and me.
Yeah, I know what cavalier means.
Carol, why does Mommy want a new job?
Because it's a great opportunity.
Why?
Well, she'll have the kind of job that most women only dream of.
Why?
Chrissy, I'm going to speak to you not as a sister, but as a sister.
Okay.
Now, as you may have noticed, we live in a male-dominated society wherein women are mere chattel. Our mother, our sister, has the rare opportunity to shrug off the yoke of male oppression. Are you with me so far?
Did you know your nostrils move when you say the letter M?
I'm sorry, Chrissy. I think I was speaking over your head.
It's okay. When we drive to Washington, you can explain how Mommy's my sister.
Oh, sweetheart, if we move to Washington, I'm not going.
You're not?
No, I'm going to stay at Columbia and live in the dorms. And that way I can be closer to Dwight.
And you're happy about that?
Well, of course I am.
That means I'll never see you again.
Well, sure you will. We're family, and family stays in touch. It's the law.
It is?
Mm-hmm. I'm going to be visiting so much, you're going to get tired of looking at this face.
Oh, the way Ben and Mike do.
No, not the way Ben and Mike do. But no matter what, we'll always be close.
Pinky swear.
Hug swear.
I love you.
I love you.
Carol, that was really sweet.
Mom, snap out of it. I was talking to a kid. The truth would have warped her.
The truth?
Oh, sure, we'll see a lot of each other in the beginning. But before long, it'll just be Thanksgiving and Christmas. And before you know it, Our spouses won't want to come over on the holidays. And before long, we'll be faxing Valentine's and sending cards that say, sorry, I forgot your birthday.
Carol, our birthdays are in the same month.
Which only makes it all the more tragic.
Well, we really won't have as much time to spend together.
Okay. Now it's your turn to share a secret.
All right. Remember the Saturday night last month when Debbie Shelley and I went to the library and then we spent the night at Debbie's house?
Yeah.
Well, we didn't study at all.
Yeah.
Instead, we took the train into Manhattan and went to this really neat dance club in Soho.
Yeah?
You had to be 21 to get into this place. Debbie and Shelley were about to give up. But I was so cool. I greased the doorman.
Greased?
I slipped him $20 to let us in. I mean, is that neat or what? It was so great. We danced till 4 in the morning with these guys who didn't even speak English. And then we took the train back and snuck into her room and were sound asleep before her parents ever woke up. And to this day, no one is any the wiser.
I'm gonna miss our heart-to-heart talks. Oh, Carol, maybe I'm crazy to even consider moving the family.
Oh, come on, Mom, I admire you. I mean, there are very few women who are willing to deny their family's needs and think only of themselves.
Oh, Jason, the more I think about this move, the more I question whether taking this job is right.
Of course it is.
Well, how can you say that when we'll be upsetting our children's lives?
Our children love to be upset. It's about time we got even. I don't mean to make light of this, Maggie. It's just that change is good for people. Makes them stronger.
Yeah, or scars them for life. Remember the time I rearranged the living room furniture? Mm. Ben had nightmares for a week.
Not to mention black and blue legs. Oh, kids have been uprooted before, Maggie. Remember that weekend we all had to spend at Mike's?
I can't sleep on this floor. Things are crawling on me.
Oh, I'm sorry, honey. Just climb in.
Oh.
Wait a second. The snotball gets bedded, I have to suffer on the floor? Forget it.
Hey, wait a minute. Wait a whole time out. I'm the one who owns the bed, and you guys are going to sleep in it? I'm supposed to sleep on the floor? No way. Make room.
Oh, Mike, over. Come on.
Ow! Hey, Mike, that's my foot.
Yes, I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, who's got their elbow on their back? Many people in this bed.
Yes, Relax. I've had twice as many people in this baby. Don't worry, they were all guys.
Wait, did you have the bed?
Heck no. Hey, wait a minute. We're not wetting the bed. The bed's waiting us.
What?
Maggie, don't you dare turn this job down unless you have a real good reason.
It is a great job.
Mm-hmm. Trust me, the kids are going to be just fine once they get used to the idea of moving. Yeah.
Come in.
Guys, I just wanted to say goodnight. By the way, you guys can go on ahead to Washington, but I'm not going.
Sweetheart, can we talk about this?
Why bother? I mean, you're not going to listen to me anyway.
Benjamin Hubert Horatio Humphrey Seaver. That's not fair.
If life was fair, my middle name would be Bill. I hate this.
I mean, Mike and Carol get to decide what they want. You guys treat me like I'm a little baby.
We do not.
You do too, do too, do too.
Oh, no, let me do this. You're going to hurt yourself.
Could you cut it into four little soldiers for me?
Come on, Ben. I know you're upset, but can we please look at this rationally?
Okay, I'll be rational. You've hired a private detective to follow me around school. And now he's told you that I've finally shed my last vestiges of geekosity. And now you've decided to smash my life into little pieces with the help of a woman senator who looks like Joe Pesci.
Come on, honey, don't get carried away.
Me? I never get carried away.
What's your point?
I think that if he was married before, that probably means he had another wife.
Oh, no.
And I wouldn't be a bit surprised if they're living somewhere on Long Island.
Yeah, Dad wouldn't want to live far away from his kids.
What kids?
The ones he goes and visits when he says he's gonna get a haircut.
Ben!
I got it! Dad's other wife cuts his hair while he plays with his other kids. So he couldn't live far away. I bet right on this street. Maybe they come over here when we're at school. And wear our clothes. And play with our stuff. That's why my room gets so messed up.
All right. I almost never get carried away. Look, Mom, can't you wait and find a great job till after I'm out of high school?
Oh, sweetheart, I wish I could, but this is a once-in-a-lifetime chance. Now, I know how you feel. This is going to be a big change for all of us. I'm worried, too.
Not half as much as I am.
You've always been there for me. Ben, I know this has been a big change for all of us. And I worry about not being here for you because, well, you're the youngest. And I worry about not being here for Carol because she's a girl and she needs her mother. And I worry about not being here for Mike to keep him from accidentally blowing something up. And believe me, I worry about leaving your father here to cope with all you monsters.
You shouldn't worry so much, Mom. You'll make yourself crazy.
I love you, little pumpkin head. Oh, pumpkin head.
Hey, Ben. Can I borrow $10?
Help yourself. Top drawer rolled up inside my Wayne's World underwear.
Hello, Earth to Ben. How many times have I told you? You never lend money to family. Boy, Mom's right. You are depressed.
Not anymore. I'm just gonna ask Stinky's parents if I can stay with them till I finish high school.
Ben, I don't think you want to stay with the people who made Stinky.
Fine. Then I'll sleep in the school library. I'm sure they still have your cot set up.
Benny, come on. Do I look upset at the prospect of being tossed out of my cushy little bachelor pad? No. And you know why? Not gonna happen.
What?
Ben, come on. Mom is just going through some post-nasal midlife crisis. I mean, she just wants to think about change.
Mike, grow a beard. Mom wouldn't pull our chains for nothing.
Okay, all right, well, let's just say in a million-to-one shot, she actually goes through with this whole job change, and you move to Washington. Now, I know you think Washington is probably filled with sleazy crooks and con artists, but relax. There's room for one more.
Mike, leave my room.
Benny, look, we would be talking about a whole new school who knows absolutely nothing about the Surefire Seaver scams.
Yeah, I don't know.
Look, Benny, if they were really going to drag you all the way to Washington, they'd have already tried to bribe you with a car or something.
A car? What would I do with a car?
Now remember, when I say now, you pop the clutch.
Like I said before, I got it.
Ah, that was then. This is now. The brake! Benny, the brake!
He doesn't need either one of us now.
Oh, I'm alive. I'm alive. I'm alive. Hey, this is fun. And I'm not going to be 18 for another 3 years.
Yeah, but in 6 months, you'll be 16. And that's the legal driving age in D.C.
Well, I rounded up all the kids, Miss Capitol Hill. You could say the house is assembled and they're awaiting your State of the Union address.
Jason, these Washington puns are starting to get on my nerves. Would you please stop?
Whatever you say, dear. Hail to the chief. I know it's a little bit dorky, but hey, I'm excited about you taking this job.
Oh, honey, I've thought a lot about this, and Ben's never going to warm up to this move. I just don't think I can go through with it.
Honey, there's a chance of a lifetime. This thing means a lot to you.
Well, it does, or it did. Look, Ben's going to be in college in 3 years. I'll call Senator Howard then.
Well, the position just may be filled by then, Maggie. Or maybe Chrissy won't want you to move to Washington. By the time you finally decide to follow your dream, Maggie, it's going to be time to retire.
Honey, you told me that I shouldn't pass up on this opportunity unless I had a heck of a reason. Well, I just think that hurting one of my kids is reason enough.
All right. That's your decision. I support it.
Mom, I've got to talk to you. Before you make your decision, I think you should hear how I really feel.
Carol, what are you doing?
Seeing if this will fit in my dorm room. I'm sure Mom will give it to me if I make her feel guilty enough.
Carol, Mom is not going anywhere.
Mike, there is no way she could pass up a job like this.
Carol, I'm telling you, not gonna happen.
Okay, everyone, I've made my decision. I'm taking the job in Washington.
You are?
Yeah.
And I'm getting a car.
You are?
Hi, I rushed over as fast as I could.
I'm gonna get right to the point. Kate, let's do it.
Pardon me?
Let's get married.
Mike, I waited so long to hear you say that. I'm so happy.
Oh, great, then it's settled.
Well, this is so unexpected.
Oh, well, Kate, with my folks still in the house and moving to Washington, D.C.
Your parents are moving to Washington?
I mean, I've got to start thinking about my future. I mean, our future, dearest. I mean, let's face it, Kate, it's going to be tough.
Oh, I know, but we can do it. I mean, we might have to scrimp and save it.
Oh, I am so glad you're up for this. I mean, I was actually thinking that I was going to have to find myself a new apartment.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah, but now we can stay at your place.
My place?
Oh, then we agree. Oh, I was worried there for a second. I mean, let's face it, my mom is not going to be around to do my cooking and cleaning anymore.
Maybe. But if we were married, then I could do those things.
Exactly.
I mean, I could keep the refrigerator full, and I could help pay those bills.
Oh, Kate, you're reading my mind.
Hey, you could have your friends over, and I could wait on them hand and foot.
We are so in sync, Kate. This is the perfect time for us to be together.
Mike, you're amazing.
Well, thank you, but I did have a whole night to work this out.
Mike Seaver, I've got three little words for you.
I love you.
Get a dog.
Come on, Mr. Blowhole, you're being a baby about this.
Chrissy, what are you doing?
Ben, I'm not gonna lie to you. We've got a problem here.
What is it?
Well, I was carrying some boxes to the garage, and all of a sudden, Mr. Blowhole made a run for it. He says he's not going to Washington.
Oh, well, tough luck.
Ben! Would you talk to him for me?
Chris, he's a stuffed animal.
Shh, you'll hurt his feelings.
Okay. Say there, Blowhole. Listen up. We're moving. Deal with it.
Mr. Blowhole, that wasn't very nice.
What did he say?
He says you're acting like a poopy head.
Wait a minute. I don't need attitude from a whale.
Ben! You can't just leave him. We've got to do something.
Why me?
Here, Ben, you want to hold her?
You're big brother, Ben, now.
I'm gonna be a good big brother, Chris. You'll see.
Okay. Now, why won't he go to Washington?
He's afraid he won't have any friends to play with.
Well, does he know that I'm gonna be there, and so will Mom and Dad?
I'm talking friends here, Ben. You know, his kind.
Oh, maybe he'll listen to this, This big butt thing here.
That's for the big jeans.
And she needs to cut back on the honey.
You wonder why all the animals talk behind your back.
Hi there, Mr. Blowhole.
Oh, Ben, one thing. Mr. Blowhole's good friends with Papa Pig.
Okay.
Now, see here, Blowhole. You have to move with the family.
Mr. Blowhole says he was born in this house, and it's the only place he ever lived.
Well, Washington, D.C. is a nice place to live.
Ben, he's scared.
Don't be scared, Mr. Blowhole. We're your family. And when a family goes somewhere, they have nothing to be afraid of.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What? Mr. Blowhole says he'll go.
Yay!
And Mr. Blowhole wants to give you the biggest kiss of all.
Oh, that's all right.
Come on. Kiss Mr. Blowhole.
Okay. Come here, Blowhole. Pucker up. You see, Blowhole here, he didn't want to go. And Chrissy, she... Why me?
Hey, Dad. I think it's time we have a guy-to-guy talk.
Yeah, well, that would be nice, Mike, but I'm a little busy right now.
Oh, well, that's up to you, Dad, but can you afford to put your future on hold?
Oh, my God, you've got a job selling life insurance.
No, Dad, it's just that, I mean, did you know that moving can be one of life's most stressful experiences? I mean, it's right up there with losing a loved one and listening to Ben eat.
Okay, what's this all about?
The truth?
Well, yeah, after 20 years, that would be a refreshing change.
Okay, Dad, the truth is that with you and Mom moving to Washington, I don't know what's going to happen to me.
I didn't know you felt that way.
Yeah, well, either did I until I found myself proposing to Kate.
You proposed? My gay congrats!
She turned me down. I guess the woman's allergic to cooking and cleaning.
You mentioned cooking and cleaning in a proposal?
Well, that's not the only thing I said, Dad. I mean, I also covered love and rent.
Well, you can't get married out of convenience.
Why not?
Because marriage isn't about convenience, Mike. It's about compromise. Look at me, I'm moving my practice to Washington.
You're moving all your nutcases to Washington?
No, there are plenty of nutcases in Washington. And they're not nutcases, Mike. No, it's just like, hey, when I heard about the move, I said, forget it. But the thing about a relationship is that sometimes you have to consider another person's needs before your own. Put yours on hold.
Dad, that's exactly what I asked Kate to do. And she said no.
Mike, what I meant was maybe you could put Kate's needs first. But don't let us moving to Washington throw you into a panic, Mike. You're going to be able to fend for yourself. You have grown up.
I have?
Hmm. Oh, yeah. You're ready for responsibility now. Okay, look, here's the deal. I'll give you a little more freedom. You've got to promise me a lot more responsibility.
Hey, no problem, Dad. I swear, I am ready for total responsibility.
Mike, I'm not ready for total responsibility. Some responsibility.
I hear you, Dad. I'm going to take responsibility for my life. And I'm going to start by apologizing to Kate. I just wish I knew the right way to do it.
Well, if you don't mind me saying so, I think that the best way to a woman's heart is sincerity. And if that's not working, try a little gift.
Candygram.
Mike, is that you?
Oh, it's a 150-pound bonbon. Unwrap me.
Pass.
Well, then at least read the card.
I heard everything you had to say this morning.
Kate, come on, it's hot in here. I blacked out twice already.
For you.
Thank you.
I had candles going, but I singed my hair.
I've got something on the stove. Excuse me.
Kate, look, I'm sorry about this morning. Kate, it's just that with my folks moving to Washington, I went temporarily insane. Asking you to marry me was just a knee-jerk reaction.
I got it half right.
Kate, what I'm trying to say is that I'm selfish and immature and I'm thoughtless and rude and spoiled and ready to... Stop me anytime here.
I will when I disagree.
Kate, I'm asking you to marry me.
Again?
Yes. When the time is right.
Huh?
Well, first I want to finish school and start a career so that I can give you the life that you deserve. So will you marry me? Someday?
Maybe. Ask me. Someday.
Hey, be careful. You're going to crush my packing peanuts. Hey, Carol. Carol, what are you doing?
Just looking, thinking. Seems so weird to think that soon I won't be welcome in this house.
Well, it seems like you should be used to that by now. Sorry. It's on autopilot.
We haven't had the greatest relationship, have we?
Well, I don't know why you say that. Hello? Hey! I'm just getting a fly! Ow! Hey! That hurt!
Hello? Oh, hi, Bobby. Lucky you caught me. I was just heading out the door.
Well, at least we won't be living under the same roof at each other's throats all the time.
Yeah, I mean, what a relief. I mean, after 21 years together, we need a break.
Wow, 21 years.
Yeah.
You have always been obnoxious.
Like, read this line.
I hate this book.
Oh, how do you know you haven't even read it?
I heard about it. I'll just wait for the movie.
Mikey.
Okay, okay. Don't help me. Sea Spot Run said this. Run, run, run. See him wag his tail.
Maggie, did you just...
I heard her. She can read. 4 years old and she can read.
It's a miracle.
Oh, it's fantastic.
Our little genius.
Oh, I've got to go call Mom and Dad.
Yes, I'll get the paper for her.
Turn the page. I want to see how it comes out. You always got to make me look bad, don't you? Yeah. Big deal. So what if you can read? It doesn't mean nothing. Sure it does. It means I'm smart and you're stupid. Oh, yeah? Yeah. You're never even going to graduate. I bet you 50 bucks I do. Okay, sucker. Let's graduate me.
Well, I graduated, didn't I?
Yeah. And you were smart enough to stop me from making the biggest mistake of my life.
What are you talking about? You're still dating Dwight.
No, I was talking about the time I wanted to get a nose job.
If you think I'm even aware that you've been calling me funny looking for the past all my life, no, you're crazy.
Well, Carol, why would you even listen to me? Come on, Carol, look, you're my sister. All right, I'm supposed to call you ugly. It's my job.
What, now I suppose you're going to say you didn't mean it?
Look, all right, look, did you mean it all those times you called me so incredibly stupid? All right, bad example. Carol, come on, huh? This is brother and sister stuff here, you know? I mean, look, Eddie calls his sister ugly. Boner thinks his sister is ugly.
Boner's sister is ugly.
That's not the point, Carol. The point is, you're not ugly. I mean, as a matter of fact, in the last couple of years, you've been looking kind of... You've been getting better looking.
Oh, sure.
Carol, this is tough for me, all right? Look, I mean, I see the way guys look at you, and I know that look.
Yeah?
Yeah, I mean, you know, and when your friends look at your sister that way, it's kind of weird.
So you're saying,
Bernie.
What?
pretty. I said I think you're kind of pretty.
Wow. You think I'm pretty?
Yeah, look, and if you have any sensitivity at all, you will never, ever tell anyone I said you weren't pretty.
Hey, you know, Carol, I've been thinking. I mean, after 21 years of my zingers, you shouldn't just have to quit cold turkey.
What?
Well, I think we should get together every once in a while. Just to make sure that, well, that you don't start getting the idea that you're normal or anything.
You do that for me?
Sure.
Jerk.
Geek.
Okay, for our last meal, we'll pretend that this is an elegant banquet with a make-believe table,
make-believe chairs,
and make-believe food. Where are those guys?
It's about time.
Hey, pizza guy.
Good, I'm starving.
Oh, great, food.
I can't believe we're actually leaving.
I know, can you believe that this is the last meal we'll ever have in this house?
That's right, sharing stale pizza.
Smelling Ben.
Is it too late to sell her with the house?
It's amazing that this house has survived four Seaver children.
I'll remember this is the house my babies grew up in.
Well, they sure were cute as little kids.
And then they grew up.
Hey, why's everybody looking at me?
Well, because you're the only guy we've ever heard of who could pull off scams in two cities at the same time. You remember the time that you snuck off to California? Mm-hmm. You left Ben and Carol to cover for you?
Mike!
I was in here first, dog breath.
Mike, don't call your sister names.
All right.
Mom, he's been in there all morning, and he says he's going to stay in through breakfast. Mike, you don't want breakfast?
No breakfast this morning, Mom.
What are you doing in there?
Whatever it is, it sure smells good.
What? Oh, what do you know, Ben? The telephone's ringing at 7:59 exactly.
Oh.
Carol?
I got it.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm really enjoying my 5 hours here in Denver. Why am I whispering?
Mike, telephone!
I'll take it upstairs.
Carol, who's on the phone?
Mike.
And Boner. He's going over to Boner's house.
Wait a minute. Mike?
Dad!
You're not going anywhere, mister.
I'm not?
Who's Dad talking to?
Mike.
Bye.
Don't worry, he's not taking off until he does his share of the shoveling.
Well, Dad, that's going to be a little tough.
Mike, I want to see you outside in 5 minutes. No excuses. Say goodbye, Boner.
Goodbye, Dr. Siva.
Hey, look, I'm not the only con artist in this house. How about Benny here? He's starting younger than I did.
Hello, God.
What are you doing?
I happen to be praying for money.
Ben, you can't pray for money. Believe me, I've tried. You actually think God's gonna send you a check or something?
Amen.
Money for the needy.
Thanks.
Come on, let's not forget about Carol.
Me? I have never pulled a scam in my life.
Oh, well, what about the time you tried to fool that recruiter from Boston College?
And Mike dragged in some bum off the street to play me in a challenging dual role.
Doc Seaver, it's a pleasure. I see you're still wearing the Boston College colors.
Oh, yeah. Say, can I get you a sherry?
Oh, thank you.
Great, more for me.
is my brother Mike.
Hey, you. What's up?
So, Dr. Seaver, I understand that you're a psychiatrist.
Yeah, you better believe it.
Dr. Seaver, I'm sorry, your wife won't be joining us this evening.
Oh, yes, I'm sick about the fact that Mickey can't be here.
Mickey, isn't it Maggie?
Yeah, Mickey's just my pet name for her when we're in the sack.
Well, Carol, let me begin by saying that your high school grades are nothing short of spectacular.
Thank you.
Yeah, and can you believe she got those straight A's after missing 6 whole months because of reform school?
Reform school?
Little misunderstanding over a knife.
We're damn proud of the little slut.
Okay, all right, so one little scam, no one got hurt. But that is nothing compared to the goofy glue incident.
Goofy glue incident?
Mm. Oh, yeah, did anyone ever tell you about that one?
No.
Oh, boy. Well, it started when Carol broke that lamp that was right here.
And the genius here thought that he could glue it back together.
Yeah. Oh, perfect.
It isn't bad. Do you think it'll hold?
What, are you kidding? On a commercial, this stuff holds 5 elephants over the Grand Canyon.
Yeah, and they don't put anything on TV that isn't true.
Well, we're in the clear now. You two clean up the mess.
Carol, if I'd clean up the mess around here, you'd probably find yourself standing in a trash can out by the curb.
Come on, Ben, get up.
I can't. I'm stuck.
You're kidding, right?
No, he isn't.
What are you screaming about?
Yeah. All right, all right, put your hands on my neck, and when I pull on you, I'll throw your weight towards me, okay?
Okay.
All right, ready? 1, 2, 3. Oh, no. No, no. Oh, what are we going to do?
I never did stuff like that. I've always been a perfect angel.
Oh, well, what about the time you threw that tantrum because you thought we were all playing around after you went to bed?
Uh-huh. Yeah. Huh? Can I help it if I've got a healthy imagination?
Oh, no.
It's not fair. How come I have to go to bed and everyone else gets to stay up and have fun? I hear you laughing. I know what you do. Wait, of course he goes to bed, then party, party, party.
Well, I guess Chrissy must be asleep by now.
What do you want to do tonight?
Oh, I don't know. Want to play Barbies?
Gorgeous!
Santa Claus brought them! Oh! Oh, I'm just waiting for a special occasion.
I want to play something else. I know! Tea party! I want to play dress up! Oh, jump rope, jump rope!
We have time for everything! We have all night!
You some vegetables.
Oh, Mom, are you crazy?
Not for eating, for throwing! Hey, are you guys playing without Chrissy again?
Yeah!
Great, because look at what I brought! Pony rally for everyone!
That was funny.
Here comes. Oh, watch out. Watch yourself, baby. Well, I don't mean to break up the fun, but we've got a long drive to Washington. Guess we better hit the road.
Yeah, I gotta go break in my new landlord.
Dwight's driving me to my dorm.
Can't we stay and see what the new people look like?
rather not know.
Me either.
Oh, come on, we better get moving.
Congratulations, Growing Pains, on 7 years of laughter and love. Next, good news from MacGyver as he finds his long-lost son. The bad news is the mob wants them dead. Find out what happens on the grand finale of MacGyver, next.
I'm David Brinkley. This Sunday, crime is tearing our country apart. Our guests, the Attorney General of the United States and the new chief of the Los Angeles Police. Sunday,